Hey guys, it's Alice. So for today's video, I wanted to show you how to use these vectors to make a pattern in Illustrator. So these vectors are available for free on my website. I'll leave the link in the description. And what I'm going to do is create a new template on Illustrator. So what I'm doing is creating in inches. This is super important. So I've got it in 3 inches by 3 inches squared. And then once I have that simple template, I'm copying the vectors over and sizing them down so they fit. These vectors are all handmade and I'm super happy with them. You can make a bunch of different things with these, so feel free to use them and download them as you wish. My website is going live today, so if you aren't signed up, please do. But anyway, back to the tutorial. So what I'm going to do is grab the icons I like the most. So I have a few different flourishes. I've got flowers, I've got leaves, so I'm gonna actually only put them down the left hand side of the canvas and the top of the canvas. So you'll see I've sped this up a little bit, but you'll see that I'm just kind of arranging them, playing around with the layout and just putting them on those top two edges. Of course you can resize them, you can rotate them, you can change the color. They're fully editable. Oh my god, I can't get my words out today. So now I've got all my vectors in a position I like the look of. I'm going to highlight everything that overlaps the edge of the canvas. So I'm just going to drag it down, highlight everything, then go into edit, copy, and then this is super important, edit, paste in back. So that now means there is an identical copy right underneath the other one. So now I'm going into transform, and on the x-axis I'm going to go +3, which will move them exactly 3 inches over to the right. Once I'd moved these, I noticed that little branch wasn't placed right, so I moved that, and then I did the same on the top. So I highlighted everything that overlapped the top, copied and pasted in the back. I used the shortcuts this time, and then again, but on the y-axis, I'm adding +3 and it's going to move it down to the bottom. You'll see that there are some things overlapping. So what I'm doing now is selecting both sides at the same time. That's super important. If you're going to move anything that overlaps the edge, you need to move the other side too. So I'm just moving them over to make sure they've got a nice little gap in between. And then what I'm going to do is fill in the center. So the center you can play around with as much as you like. As long as you're not moving anything that is going over the edge of the canvas, then you're good. So I'm just going to reflect, rotate, and arrange a bunch of different vectors wherever I would like them. I actually also decided to add some little flourishes in between. That's what I really, really like about this vector pack that I made, that I added these little crosses and stars, and it added a nice little flair, and also later on I changed the colour of them. So once you've done that, I'm just changing the colour of the whole set, and you now need to create a rectangle. So you could try and line it up to the canvas. You want it to be exactly the same size as the canvas, but the easier way is to click the center of the canvas and a little box will come up, and in there you type 3 inches by 3 inches, and as we know, that is the size of our canvas. I'll just change the color, and then I'm gonna align to artboard, then click these two buttons and it's gonna fit exactly in the center and be exactly the same size as the canvas. Now right click and go to arrange center back, so it is behind all the vectors, and then again I'm just going to change the color to something that I like. And this is a instant replay because I didn't film this, but I'm now going to copy and paste in back that square I've just created. So that dark green square is now duplicated. I've now selected the one in the back, and I'm going to change the fill in that to nothing. So it's important that this has no fill at all, because that's how the pattern picks it up. So once you've done that, you need to highlight everything, open your swatches panel and literally drag it in, and you'll get a new little swatch created in there. If this doesn't work, try it again. Usually it's because the square in the back isn't completely empty, or you've done something in the wrong order, so just rewind this video and check it out. But Once that's done, if you draw a rectangle and click on that swatch, it will fill it with your pattern. So here I'm just playing around with some colours. You'll see in a second that I tried some different styles, different colours, and you can play around with it quite a lot. And I ended up with 4 cute little patterns, which I'm super happy with. Hopefully this all made sense to you guys. As always, I'm not an expert on this. I just want to share with you what I know. But if you would like to download these vectors, the link is in the top line of the description. Please do go and check out my new website. I've worked super hard on it, and I'll see you very, very soon for another video. Bye.